Tommy. Thank you so much. So my question is, in our Hindu religion, we do take rebirths until we come to a birth where we are enlightened.
And thanks liberated.
To you, and thanks to you, I don't have to worry about this birth. So my question is, like in Tamil they say, right, Pullai, Pundai, Puruvai. So we do accumulate karmas to come to this Janma. I want to you to shed some light at which stage do we start accumulating that karmas to be here?
I should say, to be here means, you mean to say in presence of Guru?
Yeah, my whole journey.
In the presence of Guru starts, the journey starts when you feel whatever you are seeing with five senses are not complete. The moment you start doubting the existence or the authority, authenticity of what you perceive through five senses and start feeling, at one time this will all go away, this is not going to be permanent. At that moment start seeking, that moment you start accumulating the karmas needed to be in the presence of the Master.
Thank you, Swami. But when I was asking, like, I know when we are with our senses, we do certain things, we accumulate the karma. But at which stage do we start accumulating that? Because like,
whenever the muscle memory and bio memory starts building, I should say more like a animal bodies, the worm, that level bodies. Okay. That is where the karma starts getting recorded.
Okay, and
Not as plants. As plants, you don't build muscle memory and bio memory.
And my sincere request, Swami, I know you were talking about the long jumps and high jumps, which I don't experience at all. And after you said, I would like rather to be in your manifesting group where I can go around and show what you can do. So I want your blessings because
Tata,
I have not got a...
I tell you, all of you are my manifesting crew. I am not going to let you, any one of you guys go, understand? All of you are my manifesting crews. And one more thing, all the tests I need to do, I have done before you came here. I have put enough of no entry boards, U-turn, left turn. One fellow decided to go to Mumbai Juhu Beach and drove 2,000 kilometers and came back. The wife asked, why you did not go to the Juhu Beach? No, I saw about Mumbai Juhu Beach left, because it left and came back.
Thanks for bringing us here, Swami.
Understand, I have put enough of left boards, enough of no entry boards, enough of U-turn, enough of dead-end boards. I have done all that before you came. After you came, it's no question of any reason, I'll make it happen.
Thank you.
It's my job now.
Agora Swamiji.
It is my job now, understand? Whatever may be your incompletions or patterns, that cannot be more powerful than Sadashiva's decision to awaken himself in you.
Thank you so much, Swami. One me.
Yes.
And one more thing. I was amazed at how the Balasans were telling about their previous lives and how they were connected to you. I know it's a lot to ask, but...
And I tell you, all the readings they get is recorded and we also go and verify. Every information is crash verified. Especially because these kids are going to build their personality based on that, I tell them it should be at least verified 3-layer. Yes, go ahead.
So I want to also know and feel and see the connection that I had with you.
Tathast.
Oh, thank you so much, Swami.
I think we will organize Akashic reading.
Thank you. So thanks for the joyride. which is also a roller coaster ride for me, but I am enjoying it.
I tell you, actually, all joy rides, even though in the plane it is a joy ride, because of internal ups and downs, it is always felt like a roller coaster ride. Actually, when you are in love, you will understand. When you are in love, even though everything is going well, you do not have a security, it will go well. So that is enough to make the whole thing roller coaster.
Agora Swami, I mean, this is regarding the 25 states of consciousness. Let me share the experience you have blessed me with. It was 12-12-12 cruise. The first day we were walking in, Swamiji was giving us a welcome hug. As I was approaching Swamiji, it was like a big magnet just pulled me in, and I didn't know what happened. When I was trying to get out, and I felt Swamiji's clothes when I was touching out, it was making a sound. It is a semi-solid state. It's last month like a tin foil sound. And I don't know how that matter becomes energy. I still at the confusion, Swamiji.
Enjoy. All this has no clarification. You can't give any clarification. You can only enjoy.
Thank you, Swamiji. Swamiji told me that was the Turiya Tita he has blessed me with. So thank you so much, Swamiji.
It is, surely it is Turiya Tita. Thank you,
Swamiji.
Agora.
Agora.
Agora. Hello. Hey, Swamiji.
Yes. Agora, Swamiji.
No, my God.
You talked about doing everything from oneness. I'm trying to understand how that applies to practical life. Is it same as saying do everything for enrichment of others? Is that what you mean by do everything from oneness?
No. Please understand. Now, it is like a, even enriching, you think it's like a job. When I say enriching, I mean, for example, if you are a cobbler, stitching the shoes, you don't have to be all the time thinking about the money you are going to get it back. Money is to run your life, to put fuel for your vehicle, to have a meal. You can always say, I'll be integrated to what I am doing and enrich these people by mending, by stitching their shoes. Money is utility value to run the life, because that is the way matrix runs. But that is not going to move my integrity towards my commitment to the people. Then even stitching the shoes is enriching. Enriching is not necessary, it should always be enlightenment giving. Sharing a meal. For example, if this integrated people start running food industry, pharmaceutical industries, whole world will become enlightened. So, when I say enriching, when I say oneness, it is being integrated to the first principle. See, in anything you do, you know the first principle. Am I right? First statement. For example, lawyer, he is committed to his client. Doctor, he is committed to life. Engineer, he is committed to the product he is delivering. The first principle of your existence. Being integrated to the first principle of your existence without the fine print footnotes. See, all of you know the first principle of your existence. Am I right? Being committed to that, being integrated to that. All the other utility transactions cannot touch the integrity of your first principle. They may be there, may not be there. But the first principle cannot be compromised. Cannot be compromised. I tell you, first principle brings strength. First principle, integrity to the first principle brings strength. That's what I did when I was attacked. I am supposed to be integrated to Sadashiva, and I am integrated. That's all. I know this strength, this power is enough for me to get out of all these problems and stand up again. I won the game. I won the game. It's a fact. Many, many did not expect I'll be again in the throne. Did not expect I'll be back in the throne. I told them, throne was not decorating me, I was decorating the throne. And it cannot be taken away from me. I was gracing the throne, not the throne was gracing me. I bow down to the throne every time out of reverence. That is different, but that doesn't grace me. I grace that. Understand? Integrity to first principle is strength. That is what Sadashiva calls it as Swadharma. He uses the word Swadharma in Agama. Means your first principle is Swadharma. All of you are very clear about your first principle. Am I right? What is your first principle? Means your declaration about you to the world. All of you know your first principle. Being integrated to that, that's all.
When you say we know the first principle, is it something that changes from time to time, isn't it?
Time to time.
Yeah.
I should say, the practical application may change time to time, but not the first principle itself. First principle itself does not change time to time. Surely it doesn't change.
Like you said, if someone becomes a doctor, or then he wants to become an engineer.
Oh no, what I am saying, that time what I said, multidimensional. That I used. Here what I said is, your main commitment, even if you are doing multidimensional, then your first principle should be, when I am declaring myself as a doctor, I am committed to life. When I am declaring myself as a lawyer, I am committed to client. When I am declaring myself as an engineer, I am committed to the delivery of the product. That's all. So that's the first principle. What I am declaring, that forms my first principle. Your first principle is your Swadharma. And being integrated to your Swadharma, without shaking or letting your integrity to be shaken by any of the outcomes and side effects, whether you are praised or blamed or showered, supported or beaten, being integrated to your first principle. Actually, after this attack, the way I stood back, won the game, this became my brand. I'm telling you, all the fellows who can think, the first thing they talk, first thing they say, after all this, if you can stand up and smile and do everything, you are made of a different metal. I'm seeing that. That became brand. Nityananda means it will be two brand. One, power manifestation. Second, he will stand. He will stand. Nothing can be done. Nothing can be done. And you know, I have not even changed my lifestyle. I have not changed any of my lifestyle. If I change my lifestyle, then I am agreeing at their accusations. I have not changed my lifestyle. Next.
Some more questions, Swamiji. In manifesting reality, you said desires don't manifest, beliefs manifest. So desire is the length and belief is the breadth. Is that?
I should say, desire is length, belief is a space of deeper breath and higher depth. It is the space between the breath and depth. Because some of your beliefs get into depth.
And where does the time factor, time and action come into picture? Like how long does it take?
It depends on the depth. If the depth is more, it touches the time. If the depth is less, it is touching the breath. It's like a 5 blocks, one on the another. If the length is too much, it is touching the breath. If the breath is too much, it is touching the depth. If the depth is too much, it is touching the time. If the time is too much, it is touching the space.
So, what decides how long it will take? Something.
Intensity.
Intensity of belief?
Intensity of your decision, conscious decision. Even belief, you see, I should say, belief is not depth. Your will is depth. Belief does not make depth. Your will makes depth. Conscious will makes depth.
And one final question, Swamiji.
Yes.
What is the difference between love and devotion?
If you know, it is Sadashiva manifesting as my Guru, and this form will lead me to that Sadashivatva, it is devotion. If you think, as of now I do not know anything about Sadashiva, the way he is expressing as my Guru, I am in love with him, let me just follow, it is love. I tell you, love is great in the beginning, but not enough. It has to ripen into devotion. Only then, the ultimate is experienced as experience. Love is great in the beginning, no doubt about it, but it has to ripen into devotion.
Purusha, Tathpurusha, Swamiji.
Satyo Jata is the first word I heard. Yes.
Nityananam Swamiji. Closer. This is good. Okay. So I theoretically I understand the 11 dimensions, the 25 states. But earlier in one of the two-way videos, you said that our consciousness, like our egos, would become irrelevant. The whole concept of I would change, and that hasn't hit me quite yet. How can I use that information to make my I consciousness irrelevant?
So, with this more and more power manifestation, already I am seeing your idea about your I has started expanding. See, from the day you came and now, don't you see so many new possibilities of your life?
So new possibilities, definitely. But I guess I'm expecting
that itself, you will start perceiving only if your eye expands, not otherwise. If the eye doesn't expand. See, when I said yesterday, all of you be your own boss, how many of you decided at least next 1 year I am going to be my own boss? All of you add eye expansion, otherwise you are not going to be thinking of this. You did not think till now. Now you, even if you are able to conceive it, perceive it, it is possible. Your eye has changed. So the expansion of eye and expansion of possibilities is, see, expansion of possibilities is the symptom that expansion of eye has happened.
Okay, so in order to continue the process or make it even, expand even faster or further, would you say is that just through manifesting powers or is there something else that we could do?
I think manifesting powers is the best short way.